You know what bothers me about this research room? We could definitely fit like a fucking resistance relay or some shit in here. He's got so much fucking space that he doesn't need. Even fucking thing does right here. Like, she's got boxes here. I guess this is sort of acceptable, but like this, like, why are we clearing out machinery for this shit? Like, definitely, like, he could have like a lab right here, but he's like, no, I don't want him. He's a fucking dick. I'm just saying that. Anyways, hey everyone, welcome back to XCOM. Doing a UFO launch mission. All right, we brought Mr. Shiv along just because. I don't know. Just because. I also have a one weapon upgrade to still give to somebody. I can give him like the scrub thing. I called it the unscrub though. I don't know. Who do we want to miss shots to still do damage with? To be honest, probably him. He's the one that's probably gonna be the one most likely to miss. So, no offense to Mr. Shiv, but yeah. I think that's pretty good though. I still kept the mimic beacon, same loadout essentially from last one. On different people essentially. Didn't get anything new, so let's go fuck up a UFO though.
Sky Ranger deployed.
In position to drop.
A group of resistance operatives working out of this area managed to disable a grounded UFO. We're deploying near their last position to take control of the site. Neutralize all hostile contacts and seize whatever cargo you can get your hands on.
So this mission is supposed to be difficult, so.
Five UFO site coordinates locked in. Move to secure the area, neutralize all hostiles.
That looks cool as shit.
Nuestra posición está oculta.
Alright, what do we have for... Where's stealth at? I might retrain Witchell and make him work on the art of stealth. Just because I've really actually liked it. Alright. And, well, first there's me and Kyle. Me and Kyle need the vantage points. Can I even make it up here at all? Or no? That just exists to... This is like the old gas stations from XCOM 1. Well, XCOM Enemy Unknown. But still kind of XCOM 1. Here's the problem. I don't think this is actually a vantage point, and I can't make it up here, which is quite unfortunate. So I can maybe go here and get some shots up in that direction, but that's all I can hope for at this point. Which is really unfortunate, to be honest. Kyle's still a pistoler, so I'm not gonna fucking give him shit for the fact that I'm not gonna move in there, so... It's all good.
Got it, moving.
Alright, Mr. Shiv.
Roger.
It's a bit of a different area, but I don't think there'd be anyone up here. And we'd still be in concealment anyway, so it doesn't even matter. I don't even know I'm particularly worried about, like, entering one square with them. Actually, why did he go there? I thought I moved him into the cover there. Alright. Let's see. Hello, stealth. I guess we're gonna start over here. And move over to the big trees here. There would be patrols, wouldn't there? What else do we have? We also have a nice little guard post here. That could be a nice place to for a sniper roost.
Affirmative. Moving out.
I know I'm really about the sniper roost here, but I can't help it. What can I say? Alright. Question is, could I even make it there? There's a ladder there. And there's some cover there. So yeah, the answer is yes.
Los,
yes, we could.
Los. Okay.
I got a little bit worried when my fucking camera started moving. I'm like, did I just get my ass spotted by something? I don't like it when the camera just moves on its own, kind of like that. Alright, and... I think continuing to move up is a good idea. We're not under any time limit, are we? No, we're not. Alright, we got our first little guys here of the day. Alright, well, let's have a look at if I can make it up there with my sniper. The idea is we don't want him to fucking go into break concealment range. However, easily can bring him into here. It doesn't look like any of these squares are going to be a problem. And if they are, well, there's always loading. And I can still see them all perfectly fine. Alright, so that is probably too dangerously close. A lot of shitty cover here. So here's what we're gonna do. Kyle can still be back there. Stealth will stay there, because we don't want stealth to break stealth. Cand will, I think, go over here.
Getting it done.
Stealth can fuck off. This person goes go here. Kyle will stay sort of at range. This person will go here. Come on, Kyle. Where can you go? I guess over here.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Alright, I'm gonna move stealth farther back, I think.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Actually, a little bit further back. Or actually, maybe just over here, to be honest. It's just, I know that flanking removes their cover, so.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Alright, so they're gonna move slightly more this way. Alright, this is actually probably good for us in a way. So who can we open up on? Just the Advent Stun Lancer. Which, as I said, is actually not the worst thing in the world.
Affirmativo, en camino. On Overwatch.
So he's definitely gonna be the one to open up. Mr. Shiv will just stand by. And let's get Killzone going. Do it like this.
Bereich gesperrt.
Oh yeah, that's right, she has Killzone too. Isn't that Gabe? No, I'm just joking, but yes. She has Killzone as well. Ah, that guy's just fucking dead.
Hostile neutralized. They spotted us.
Armor shredded, that's quite fortunate for me.
Muss besser zielen.
So his armor got shredded before my sniper took a shot. That is the best fucking thing in the world. Holy shit. And he even dropped a goodie for me. Alright, so I think he has the thing where he's shaken. One second. What does this even do? It's a will penalty. Remote hacking and medical protocol. So I think he's got the thing where he does 2 damage guaranteed to somebody, so all we really have to do is, I know it's low cover, but it doesn't fucking matter because just watch. Oh no, shitty chance to hit. Still 2 damage, doesn't matter. Alright, that worked out pretty well.
1-5, we just picked up an outbound signal coming from the UFO. It's some kind of distress beacon. You need to get inside that ship and shut down the signal before they send their whole fleet after us.
Okay. That's an interesting note.
I'm on the move.
Alright, we got some duders here. However, they're kind of far, so I think we're okay to just sprint up. Let's see the angle that they're at. Okay, so she can see them because she can see the door? Or wait, that door looks closed to me. Dude, is this some bullshit again where I can see through walls? It kind of looks like it, to be honest. Fuck. Alright, well. Because that is kind of problematic. I need to get up there, but at the same time I don't want to. Yeah, we're going to risk Mr. Shiv's life, I think. I don't know. Like, because we can see them through the wall right now. So it's a debate of what wall are they seeing me through. Okay, you know what? There's actually a good way of determining this. Okay, so here's what I'm going on now. Because I do not see the crosshair, I assume that he doesn't have line of sight if I move here. And I think that's a safe thing to bet. Yep. That was a good bet. Alright, we also need to pick up this weapon over here. I'm gonna just move all the way up here with Ken. Kyle will move to these trees. We're just gonna sprint the fuck up. And reload.
Holen wir sie uns! Bestätigt! Überwachung läuft!
We need the meld, so that's why we're getting the meld. Alright, so let's start with this guy. And what do we pick up from this? An autoloader. Grant a limited number of free loop reloads, so I guess it's just one since it's not advanced. Free reload is quite kind of nice. You think? Alright. I didn't want stealth to get another kind of like angle on them.
Good copy. Moving on target.
Alright, how many more turns do we have? We have 5 turns. So I think a good option here is breach this door. And then we just kind of make it over to there. I'm really hesitant to just sprint to that door like this. To be honest, I think we can't even do that anyways, because our entire team needs to kind of move up here first.
Aha, me muevo.
Kyle will go here.
Already there.
It's really risky that, because it's just like we already know how they'd like to apparently look to see me through the walls.
I guess that'll be okay.
Yeah, we're gonna just now move up with the sniper now.
Bin dabei.
Alright, let's get ready to breach the door then. Man, this is just like classic fucking XCOM Enemy Unknown now. Where's Kyle? Kyle can definitely just go right over here to this door. Or actually maybe to just to that side. Yeah, that's good.
Stepping off.
Oh, there we go again. Through the walls. There's like a crack in the door or something? Like, these are closed doors. They saw him at about this point, which is why I'm thinking it's like some kind of angle through the doors. Yeah, now this is regarded as a flank, so fuck this. We're loading back. That is 100%. There's no way that isn't a glitch. And then someone's in the comments is going to tell me exactly why that's happening, and then I'm going to get pissed at myself for thinking of whatever I'm thinking right now. The fuck is that? This thing blew the fuck up. Alright. Let's try moving Kyle over here and see if it's like if it doesn't get triggered now. Otherwise I'm gonna load it again. I'm gonna load it again. Alright. I don't know what exactly the point is of which it does that, but like that's like I don't know. I'm just saying to me it really appears like all the doors are closed. Like, I'm trying to, like, it's difficult to see, but I can say almost with 100% certainty that yes. Or is that a window? Is this a window? Is that maybe what it is? That doesn't look like a window to me. And they're also spotting him right here, so, and I'm really curious to know if it's just my fault or what. That's not a window, either. These are quite solid. I don't know why you need windows in space, though. Alright, well, let's bring Kyle maybe over here. Maybe this time they won't get caught. Yep, he got caught. Alright, let me just fucking not deal with this. Constantly, like, it's a flank. It counts as a flank every time. You know what? I have another idea of how to deal with this. Nah, that would be cheesing it. I'm thinking, I could just blow a hole open in the UFO. And just fucking just kill them, like, now. But that's kind of bullshit, though, to do that. I mean, to be honest, though, I think I might. Because I'm just like, I'm kind of in a shit spot because every time I go over here, I think it just they spot me. Oh no, they didn't spot me this time.
The power supply on this ship.
Oh, now I see them.
Likely to be a newer variation of the Illyrian core driving the Avengers systems.
Okay, we totally saw him. Okay, we totally saw him there, and the game just like I got away with it that time.
Enseguida.
Like, I'm trying not to bullshit this thing, look like, out. But it's difficult to, because it's just, like, there's this one spot that apparently they can just see me in, and I'm starting to fucking hate my life now.
Affirmative.
Movimiento enemigo delante.
And we know they're behind the door. Alright. Now let's pretend this is a bug-free game, and I'm, like, fucking, like, tactical, like, I don't know they're there, guys. Herp derp. Oh, open the door. Breach and clear. Oh, wait.
Menace 1-5, that's the distress beacon. Move in and disable it before the aliens get a bead on the UFO.
What a shocker, they're there. Alright. Alright, because I don't want to cheese it that much, guys. Like, come on. That's a good shot on that guy. Why is my chance to hit so high? High cover, negative 40. Alright, do we want to like blow some holes and shit? Yeah, I think we do. Where's Cant?
I'm trusting you here.
As much as we want to keep this intact. I'm pretty sure these are just walls and not supplies. Okay, apparently the UFO walls are now kind of more explosion proof. As I have just learned just now. Fine. Headshot. Alright, where's the other guy? Alright, I have an idea of how to deal with this. Alright, so I know this looks like, oh, you're moving him to half cover, Mike. What are you doing? It's because we still have that guy. Oh, no we don't. Okay. I may have made a terrible decision. Alright, change of plans, guys. We're running the fuck back into this place that is questionable cover. Dude, I totally should do, like, in the zone.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Totally, holy shit, look at this fucking shit. Dude, totally going for that. Oh, one damage. Or, wait, no, now she's gonna split, isn't she?
I'm busted.
Alright, Kyle. What's Kyle got? Mimic Beacon. Definitely gonna do that. They love mimic beacons. Alright, Mr. Shiv, what can Mr. Shiv do? He's got the guaranteed damage, so. That's what we're gonna do with him. Probably could have moved him over there, but that's fine. Alright, now let's see what happens, what goes on now. Bind failed? Of course it did. I love the soldier thing so much. Oh my god, I'm gonna get okay. For now on, I think one of my grenaders is gonna get it. It makes him so retarded. Holy shit, dude, Holoduke is the best. This is like the most overpowered piece of shit I've ever seen. I think we want to fire our sniper with this. That's like, that's 6 to 8 damage, plus the pistol being, 3 to 4. Let's try this out. Yeah, that definitely did it.
Kill confirmed.
Alright. Oh, Zan can remotely hack that, can't he? Where's Zan? Or no, we have Mr. Shiv for that now. Mr. Shiv's our hacker now. our lead hacker.
Nessun problema.
Yes. We can turn it off.
Accesso al sistema.
That dude, okay, having at least one specialist on your team is just so fucking useful now. Alright. Delays current Darkvin projects by 2 weeks, or reduce research time is 14%. I think we're gonna do this. Definitely could have done this, apparently. Whatever. That's a nice little perk though.
Sono dentro.
We've knocked out the alien distress signal. Looks like the skies are quiet.
Alright. Let's see what we got now. Sectoid. Me. That's a fucking great chance. Chance to hit. It's through walls again. Like, this kind of shit just makes me question everything. Alright, I'm gonna suppress this one. And here's the plan with this one. This is not a door. Wait, it says enhanced squad sight? I get squad sight? Dude, there's no fucking way. Oh, I can't kill zone now. That's a fucking terrible piece of cover. Fine. Oh, we killed him anyways. Okay, that was totally useless on my part.
I got it, right?
Oh, Adam saw the turn. I think we pretty much killed them all. It's just a matter of this guy, but I think he can graze the shot. So I think I'd rather put him into a position where he can get overwatched. I mean, it might have to be the low cover, but Adam doesn't have suppression, does he? No, he has demolition, though. I kind of wish I got suppression on him, to be perfectly honest. Like, it's not a flank anyway, so... Let's just prevent him from moving and flanking the other person I have. Because he's usually less likely to move, but I think he was afraid of that. Yeah, that's what I was afraid of right here. Oh no, it's... She's bound. If only I had kill zone. Alright. We can shoot him. Kyle will save the day. Maybe.
I'm on the move.
No, Kyle cannot save the day.
Vado.
Can. Yes, we should save the day. Yes, he can.
Da manuale. Mi farebbero comodo delle munizioni.
Mission accomplished.
So that's an interesting thing to note. The fucking kill zone takes 2 turns, even though it's a shotgun. But that's actually pretty insane, though. It's kind of difficult to like break her concealment on purpose and then do that, because she's not a sniper, though. So it's like it's a half great thing, half bad thing, because it's like it's kill zone on a shotgunner. So she has squad sight, and it's useless for her to have squad sight, also. But it's still interesting. I'm pretty sure there's 1 or 2 opportunities I'm gonna have where that's actually like really, 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 really cool. So, I guess we'll see. I was kind of excited to use it, but it's just like when I figured out it was gonna be another turn, it's like, oh, I don't know what to do with that anymore.
Good work out there, Commander. We're one step closer to taking back our planet.
Alright, so Kyle can now have lightning hands. It says, fire pistol at the target. This does not cost an action. It has a 3-turn cooldown. So it does not prevent use of the sniper rifle in the same turn. Pretty useful. The other option was Deadeye. Honestly, I think like in most cases, like lightning hands is probably the better option there almost. Because like there's been actually a couple opportunities. I think Deadeye, because of the aim penalty, is less useful. Alright, so here we go. I had... Instead of going Revival Protocol, I did Haywire Protocol. And it's either field medic or scan the area. No, field medic every day. I mean, how could you not? So we got we still have the codex brain. We got an autoloader, some corpses, a bunch of alloys. Oh shit, a ton of supplies. Alright. And Mr. Shiv is much more happier now. Alright, let's build the laboratory.
Laboratory construction initiated.
We need to have one person speed it up. I really want to get that research speed going faster. What's our power at? Alright, it's at 19 out of 20. Let's see, what else we got? So we can purchase... We can allow another... So I guess it's another 2 gremlins. For that, and over here for the power relay, we can give ourselves how much more power? Upgrade requirements. It requires 2 power. But I guess that equates to about 5 power or something? I guess it's totally permitted. That's my assumption. But we don't need it right now, so we're gonna just leave it alone. So where did we leave off at last time? We can get a scientist. No, we're not gonna investigate that. I think the scientists we have are useless because we don't have a lab to put them in.
Setting course for Sector 1, the Arctic.
We're gonna go over there though, the Arctic. Why would we want a base in the Arctic? That's like the worst place. It's also in Russia. Nobody likes Russia. Actually, no. Russia's kind of cool.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
We got exosuit and a spider suit. Oh no, these are proving ground projects, which we'll complete immediately. We can also research Illyrium. Okay. Spider suit. Spotty records from the mainframe XCOM HQ. It was an early prototype for light armor suit with grappling hook that never came to fruition. That's what that gas station thing was for. It was for the spider suit to get a grapple on it. Okay, that's nice. Exosuit is heavy variant of our plated armor. We can maybe able to add a heavy weapon to mount directly to the armor? The fuck? And Viper autopsy. Oh yeah, so we can now complete the autopsy instantly on them.
Although I would expect to be growing more accustomed to seeing the clear intermingling of both human and alien genetic material, I must admit, this reptilian creature with such distinctive human features is surprisingly unsettling. Invasion-era reports include references to a species with some reptilian qualities, but nothing as readily apparent as this. I find it unusual, to say the least, that the subject so often referred to in the past as the Thin Man has now been revealed to actually be a genetic derivative of this wholly reptilian creature.
Battlefield medicine. Venom injected by Viper, however, contains a number of enzymes that can be used in our med kits. Okay, that's kind of good. So let's see, what do we have now? Mech breakdown, don't need to do any of this. I think I was going to do psionics. What's Illyrium for? I have a lot of Illyrium. We're going to do psionics and then I think Illyrium.
I'll see that work begins immediately, Commander. I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
What can I do for you, Commander?
You have the bonuses. We're probably actually getting the bonuses for the research.
Work is well underway, Commander.
But I think they're not... But they could be even faster if they're signed
to
a lab.
I admit it to Shin. But there is one thing I miss more than my lab equipment. Those damn juicy Advent burgers. I don't know where they get the meat. And frankly, I do not want to know.
Fucking Advent burgers.
Research is proceeding as planned, Commander.
Always about the Advent burgers, I swear to God. I want some Advent burgers now. Alright, let's see, what do we got next? Yeah, we're just gonna continue with this. Oh, no, proving ground. Never mind, no. Fuck whatever I was doing this year. Experimental ammo. Let's see. Holy shit. I want a spider suit first. Alright, there's one spider suit and then exosuit. Requires 2 Advent Trooper corpses. Okay, it's a good thing I wasn't selling this shit willy-nilly. Battlefield medicine, 8 days. Try exosuit. So it says offering spear protection and a wrist-mounted rocket launcher? Experiment a heavy weapon. Oh, we can do experimental heavy weapons now. Alright, let's see who we can equip this shit on, because I'm actually kind of curious. So myself first, what kind of, let's see the armor. The armor has 4 health and plus 1 mobility. We can also have the exosuit. Only rocket launcher available initially, additional heavy weapons in the proving grounds will unlock more weapon systems. Holy fuck!
The EXO armor suit gives our soldiers the power they need to handle heavy weapons, with the durability to match.
Okay, I am so glad I did, like, that one research station. Yeah, dude, I'm fucking, like, nodding my head. I'm like, fuck yeah. So I can have a rocket launcher. A sniper with a rocket launcher, of course. And then let's see the spider suit. So it says it's grappling on the left arm, bringing rapid elevation change. It adds mobility and increased chance of taking grazing shots instead of outright hits. The grapple module allows us to traverse the battlefield rapidly. It does not take an action to use, but scrolling down slowly does have a short cooldown.
The spider suit will improve our soldiers' chances of dodging an attack, while also providing increased agility and grappling capability.
Alright, that is totally something. I look fucking badass as shit. Alright, I think we only need one of these suits. I mean, the spider suit would also be good on the... on my, what's that soldier called? The stealth one. Dude, I'm fucking outfitted like shit. Holy fuck, man.
Just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
That stuff's like the best. Alright, we can also make predator armor. Increase protection and an additional inventory capacity for our soldiers. Hot damn. We need 150 supplies for that though. How much is the proving ground stuff?
I thought about trying to bring in an advent mech to see if we could integrate the Gremlin AI. The idea being to bolster our staff with robotic assistance. I eventually decided not to bring it up to Central or Tigan, at least not until things settle down some. Hey, Commander.
Yep, probably a good idea. How much supplies? Okay, so this doesn't actually require any supplies, but it does require Illyrium cores. So I think, I guess the cores are pretty rare, so I'm gonna just make one more exosuit, I think, and then that's it. Why does it take so long? Like, oh, because I have to equip an engineer. One more exosuit. Alright, we'll fucking do the outfitting a little bit later. I guess both my rocketeers can have, like, that stuff. Technically, I guess anyone can. Yeah, let's continue with this guy here. This is the Arctic, guys. It's like reverse Africa. It looks like a savanna for some reason. That is not what you wear in the Arctic.
We're reading you.
New income, 55 New supplies.
Regional contacts located.
We can go to East Asia, or we can go to West Asia. Alright, how much does this thing cost? We will make this guy. Time.
Got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
I had high hopes for the Resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
Nice. Alright, we got some changes here. Or something. So, I don't care about that one. Guaranteeing reinforcements on all guerrilla ops for a month. Yeah. That's really not a big deal, to be honest. And I don't know what the other dark event is going to be. Alright, here's your... Okay, we'll get that in a second. Course. No, I said... I want to ignore it. I want to finish the... Well, actually, we don't really need to finish it right now, do we? But it's just the fact we have to travel all the way back. We're wasting gas. I guess Central's getting a lot of fucking time to practice his fucking flying. Incoming mission. New high priority mission information. We'll go in a sec. How much supplies do I get? 152? Alright, let's make one of the armors.
Hello, Commander.
One armor. one of these.
The aptly named Predator armor should give our soldiers increased longevity in the field.
Why does Zen get it? We don't want Zen to have that. Zen's going out naked. Doesn't deserve armor. Oh, actually, we just got... Oh, no. Oh, that's for everybody. That's right. I'm so glad I did that now. Everybody gets... Of course Zen gets it. Because we all get it. I forgot all the weapons and shit. They count all the time. So let's see. What's the Predator armor do? 4 health, and the exosuits give, like, 5 health and 1 armor. Okay, that's fucking insane. I'm so glad I did that actually now. I bet someone was smashing their keyboard, wondering if I was going to be doing it. No, I did. I really wanted to. I really did. Alright. I guess there's no reason we can't do the council mission now.
Setting course for Sector 8, Mexico.
Alright, now we go back to Mexico. Why is everything down in Mexico? So we gotta extract a VIP from Advent City. We got an engineer, some intel. It's difficult. But we will do that next time, so remember. We will be watching.